This lecture is about the teleprotection schemes for distance relays or the transmission line protection. The lecture is presented by Engineer Syed Abrar Ali and is sponsored by tdconsultants.ca. For any questions, you can send email at tdconsultants.ca@gmail.com or on GTD or on syed.ali@gtdconsultants.com.pk. The prerequisite for this teleprotection course is the knowledge about the distance relay setting principles and zone of distance relays. It is not necessary to know the type of relays. These setting principles and schemes or application are applicable to any kind of distance relay. So you must know what are the basic setting principles and what is the problem and why do we need to speed up the tripping of a transmission line. I assume that you have listened to my lecture on principles of distance relay settings available on YouTube. However, I am repeating here and for your reference, I will explain you again in short. Here you can see there are three grid stations and two transmission lines, and please concentrate on the transmission line AB, between AB, station AB. Starting from left, you can see that the first zone is 80% of the line and the zone 2 is 20% plus the 50% or 60% of the second line between B and C. Similarly, if you look at B towards the direction A, so the protection distance relay setting for the same line B to A or A to B is 80% zone 1. You can see here clearly that the 20% line section is left, which will operate after a time delay. If there is a fault starting from bus bar A or grid station A towards B, you can see if the fault is between the 80% of the transmission line, then the relay will operate immediately and without any time delay. But if the fault is in zone 2 or the next 20% of the transmission line after 80%, then the relay will operate in second zone and with a time delay of 250 or 300 or more milliseconds, depending upon the type of relay, whether electromechanical or microprocessor based or digital relays. So what to do to reduce the time and to cover the full line in without any time delay, what should be done? So the scheme for this purpose is known as teleprotection, and with the scheme of teleprotection we can make the fault clear between section A and B with immediate effect, and the scheme will be shown to you in this slide or in this lecture. There are various kind of teleprotection schemes. These are known as direct transfer trip scheme, direct underreach transfer trip, permissive underreach transfer trip, and permissive overreaching transfer trip. In this lecture we will only cover DTT, direct transfer trip, because for other three here you will have to understand the underreach phenomena, the permissive phenomena, and overreaching phenomena. For underreach phenomena and for overreach phenomena of the distance relay, we have different lectures available on YouTube, and you can go and watch those lectures, that what is underreach of a transmission line distance relay and what is the overreach of a distance relay for a transmission line. Until unless you understand clearly what is underreach and what is overreach, it is very difficult to study the teleprotection schemes. However, you should just remember that teleprotection scheme is to expedite or accelerate the tripping or clearance of the fault within the zone 1 time plus the operating time of the scheme, which is a few cycles more. So if the zone 1 tripping is immediate, you can call it, then the protection scheme through the telemetry, a teleprotection will operate after another few cycles or say 10 to 15 milliseconds. So the fault clearance time will be much reduced. So again, in this lecture we will study only DTT. For other three you will have different lectures, and before that you will have to go through the underreach and overreach phenomena of the distance relay. Please go on YouTube and see those videos as well. Now, what are the communication channels or the systems used for sending the signal for the clearance of the remote end breaker, which is not covered with the zone 1 setting? So these are pilot wire, power line carrier, fiber optic and microwave. The most common communication channel used are power line carrier and fiber optics. Now how the scheme operates? Here you can see that how the scheme operates, how the DTT scheme operates. You can see here that there are three signals from the distance relay coming. Assume a distance relay at bus bar A. Zone 1, zone 2, zone 3. Zone 1 is tripping directly the relay at substation A or grid station A. And at the same time, zone 1 is sending a trip signal to the breaker at grid station B for the transmission line AB. So you can see here that the zone 1 is operating at grid station A, but at the same time it is sending a signal to the breaker at B. So both the circuit breaker at both ends of the transmission lines will trip immediately after a delay of few cycles only, because the zone 1 setting is instantaneous and a signal is sent to the other end through the pilot wire scheme or power line carrier or fiber optics to the other circuit breaker at the substation or grid station B. Similarly, at the bottom you can see a signal is received. You can see the red arrow on the left bottom. A signal is received from the grid station B. There is a relay at grid station B also, as I have shown you slide number 2 in this lecture. The signal is coming from the relay at the grid station B, zone 1, and then it is tipping the circuit breaker at the grid station A. So here you can see there is a direct tripping of the grid station breaker at A and also the breaker at grid station B with one relay only using the telecommunication channel. So this is the teleprotection scheme and known as direct transfer trip. The tripping is transferred directly to the other breaker, remote end breaker, and line is cleared from both ends in a minimum possible time. But there is a possibility of the maloperation of the signaling equipment, interferences, noise interferences as well as therefore there is a possibility that wrong tripping may occur, undesirable tripping of the breaker may occur when not required. So therefore the DTT scheme is used, but there are much improved schemes which are known as I shown you in the slides in this lecture. Those are the permissive. Permissive means the relay at the other end also permits the signal to go through and trip the breaker. when we study the permissive type of tripping, the subject will be more clear to you. But here you should know, to summarize, that if there is a transmission line between A and B, the relay at A will see fault up to 80%, and if there is a fault within 80%, the relay will trip immediately the breaker at A, but the breaker at B will be covered in second zone. So what will happen? The distance relay at A will send a signal through the power line carrier or fiber optic to the circuit breaker at the grid station B, and then trip the circuit breaker B after few cycles. So the minimum time of the clearance of the transmission line between A and B is achieved through the teleprotection. I hope I am able to convey the message. However, topic is very, very difficult, and if you will listen to the distance relay other lectures also, then gradually the subject will be clear to you. But here you must remember that the teleprotection scheme accelerates the tripping at both ends of the transmission line, and fault is cleared in minimum possible time. So this is the DTT, direct transfer trip, that no permission is required from the remote end relay for the tripping of the circuit breaker at the remote end. This is very important. No permission is required from the relay at the remote end. Just the relay at A will send a signal through the telecommunication channel and will trip the circuit breaker at B. So line will be cleared. I hope you understand the DTT philosophy. Please subscribe to our channel, and any questions you can send at tdconsultants.ca@gmail.com. Please do send your questions, and if you have in mind any other topics to be discussed, then please send us emails and we will try to accommodate and deliver the lecture on those topics as well. Any kind of relay protection, differential, overcurrent, earth fault, ground fault, restricted earth fault, etc., generation protection, motor protection, all the lectures will be placed on YouTube gradually. Thank you very much.